Hola Mis Bonitas, so this is an update of my Project Perfume for 2018. So I think I've only done one other update besides now, and today is October 4th. I guess I should show you the little bit of progress I've had on my perfumes. Now, if you watch my introduction to this, or even my 2017, my ending of it, I did bring some perfumes into my collection because they were Christmas gifts. So I'll show you the three things that were added at the end of 2017 that have actually been kind of in my collection now. So I got a Rhiannon, the Rebel Fleur, like, perfume set. So I got the actual large size perfume. I also have a, if I can find it, which is a travel size body splash, as well as a actual like travel size like mini, this little spray. So going forward for 2018, for like the actual perfumes I have some use on, this was brand new when I started off this year, and I am actually halfway done with this product. This has been in my purse almost the whole year, and I realize now that that is actually how I should have focused a little better on the different perfumes and rotating through and change them out once a month, kind of like how I do my lipstick and my makeup in general. So I actually pulled this out of my makeup bag that I carry this in, and I'm going to kind of let that sit to the side because I do enjoy this scent, and obviously I have other sizes and styles of it, but I want to try something different. Now, if you've been watching, this perfume is the oldest one in my collection. It's the Sex in the City Lust perfume, and this obviously has been a goal of mine so far. It's been in some projects, and I'm currently at the bottom line here. I'm going to hold on to it till the end of the year, maybe partially into next year, but if I don't get really any more usage out of this perfume, as much as I do enjoy it, I'm actually going to declutter it just because it is the oldest one in my collection. And if I'm not mistaken, when I first introduced this project, I was actually at the blue line and I'm at the red, and it hasn't changed since the red because I switched over to a different perfume. So that is where this is. The one that has the most progress overall for this year, but still not enough, is my Paris Hilton Can-Can perfume. When I first started this actual project, it was, if I'm not mistaken, at the brown line, because the red line was last year. So this year it started at the brown line, and I'm currently at this kind of like maroon color. When you can still see, I have some left. This is the one that I've been actually using most of the year here when I'm in my room and I actually do my makeup, or when I'm getting ready to go out, I'll spritz myself with this perfume. So this actually has the most actual progress besides my Rebel Fleur by Rhiannon. So another perfume that's had a little bit of progress, and this is actually the focus for this particular month because that's how I'm going to rotate my perfumes, is the My Babes. So it is inspired by Ari by Ariana Grande. This was a knockoff perfume that I think I got at the, I think it was at CVS that I saw it. It was on sale. So when I first started this project, the red, and it's currently at the brown, so I've used just a little bit of it, and this is the actual perfume focus for the month of October. I do like the scent, and I would like to get, I have one other imposter style version of perfume in my collection. I'd like to get both of these out by the end of next year. So this is gonna be the focus for the October month, and yeah, so that is that one. Now for everything else, there's been no progress on, maybe, well, I have a little bit. I have a super mini of Poison Girl by Dior, and when I first started, it was at the red, and it's currently at the brown, so I've used a little bit of it. I lost the actual travel size spritzer that I can actually pour this into, so I'd have to repurchase a new one, but I'm kind of saving this just because it's a more higher end perfume for later on. I think, actually, with November, I think this might be my November focus perfume, thinking about it, because November is my birthday month, and I really enjoyed this scent. And this came out around holiday last year, so 2017. So I think this actually is going to be my November focus, and maybe I'll finish off a perfume this year. Let's see. What is currently left is, this is a full size, the Rhiannon, obviously the Rebel Flor in the actual perfume, and I haven't even used any of it this year. I have, this is Beyonce's Heat perfume. I received this last year. I can't remember if it was for Christmas or my birthday from a friend, and so I've used it a few times. It's about right there. I haven't marked it, but it's a nice scent for my Lady Gaga's fame. I have the original, and I haven't really, I've used it like once or twice this year, but not really that often. I'm on the actual fence about letting this Curve by Claiborne actually go. It's an okay scent. It's not my favorite. It's probably the one of the few standout ones in my perfume collection because they're all kind of really similar of either being really woodsy or smoky or sweet. And this is the one that kind of stands out because it's a little more fresh and has like a light floral scent to it. So I'm kind of on the fence if I should let this go. I think I'll hold on to it till the end of the year, and if it doesn't really call my name, then I'm going to actually probably let this go by the end of the year. So that one I'm going to actually leave to the side along with my October scent. So those are my two choices to put on. Let's see. Here is my other fake perfume. This is an off-brand. I can't remember the name of it, but this is a knockoff of the Fame by Lady Gaga. I think the reason why I got this originally was because I was using that, and that was like my favorite. I was like, oh my god, and then I saw this, so I got it. As you can see, I've used a quarter of it. I really used a couple spritz from this as well. This scent does not last nearly as long as the original, obviously, because this is a knockoff. So this is going to be the other focus to try to get this out of my collection, because I'd rather just have the originals. A perfume that I have that I really love, and really haven't used it too often, and it smells really good. Sometimes this might be my December one. I haven't decided yet. This is True Blood's Forsaken. This I got on QVC, if I'm not mistaken, because I was a really big True Blood fan, and so I wanted the perfume. So I do like the scent, so I have this. Now, what is still in my collection for actual body splashes? Obviously, this was the first size Rebel Flor by Rhiannon that I got, and this is what caused me to ask for the perfume set later on for Christmas, and so I did get it. So I have a large size, and then obviously I have the smaller size that came in the actual set. So I think eventually I'm going to use this one, and then from the bottle like I did before, I'll use kind of get this into the more travel size friendly one to be able to kind of tote that around. And let's see, the last actual scent that I have perfume wise is my Armani Code. This is this beautiful big bottle right here. I only wear this on special occasion. This is my darkest actual perfume scent. This is one of the standoff ones in my collection as well. And I really only use this once in a while. Smelling it again, I remember why I enjoyed it. So this is also nice for like evening time, but definitely for fall and like winter. So that might be an option as well. If I don't go for the Forsaken, I might go for the Armani during December. So I have made purchases this year in 2018. I wanted to share those with you because this is an update and I need to be realistic with my collection. Now this is in a project, I think I got this right at the beginning of the year. This is my Pure Seduction fragrance mist from Victoria's Secret. And so it's one of my favorite actual like of the fruity scents that they have there. If you've like been a VS girl for years, and I'm talking before 2007, so we're talking earlier time frame, like 2000 2006, there was a scent called Passionate Kisses. This was the eventual replacement for it. So it's a very sweet scent. It has blossom, it has cherries, it has a little bit of amber. It's just wonderful. And so Pure Seduction was the one that now is more relevant to the time frame. So I got this during, I think, the semi-annual sale earlier this year, like the January version. So I'm using it. I enjoy it. I keep it in my car to kind of like spray myself to refreshen up. So their semi-annual sale always gets me, especially towards the end when it knocks off 50 to 75% off. And so I did get some things for myself. Well, I got things for other people, and then I found these things as well and decided to keep them for myself. So the first one is the Pure Seduction. This is the shimmer version. This is great for summertime. You can kind of like spray your body and have that like glitter on it, but it's the same thing. The scent doesn't last nearly as long as the actual body regular fragrance mist does. So I need to figure out a way to properly use this so I don't like let this go to waste. And then these minis were on sale. So this is an original, the Very Sexy by Victoria's Secret, the original version, just a little travel mini size. There's also the scent Tease. And then these ones were like the summertime semi-annual got to me. Very Sexy has Very Sexy 1, it has Very Sexy 2, and then they added some new ones, and I was like really intrigued by the new ones. I saw them, I was going to buy them, then I decided not to, and then I found them when it was 75% off, so I got a really good deal. This is a mini of the Very Sexy Now, and this is the actual Wild Palm. There were two versions of the Now, and I preferred this one over the second, so I got this little travel size. But then I found the Rollerball that actually has the Very Sexy Now Wild Palm, which is that one. And then this actually has a Very Sexy Now Beach. The beach is more of a floral scent, while the Wild Palm has a little bit more of that sweet scent that I really like. So yeah, those are the additional items that I have brought into my collection. So I have a lot. I'm hoping in the next October, November, and December I can focus on one particular perfume for each month and try to get some usage out of it and decide if I really want to keep it or if it's time to declutter, because ideally my goal for my beauty actual collection in general is to get down, because I have two totes of like the Tupperware drawers, and I want to get down to just one, which includes skincare, nails, as well as perfume. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, you want to know the notes about the different perfumes, let me know in the comments below. Until next time, guys, I'll be talking to you very soon. Besos. Bye.